Welcome! One of the things I like most about being a small YouTuber who collects Funko Pops and does unboxings on this channel is the opportunity to try out websites that sell Funko products that I've never tried before. And there's been one or two websites, Funko sellers here in the UK, independent Funko sellers, who I've been wanting to try for ages. One of them was Zynga Entertainment, and I was able to use them, and I've used them a couple of times now, quite recently. But there was always one more, very prominent on Instagram, ran by a guy named Paul. And of course I'm talking about Geek Garage out of Essex, England. Been desperate to use his site for a long time, and I check it quite regularly. There's stuff on there that I would like without being desperate for it, but I've always sort of had it on pre-order elsewhere, or I've just been happy to wait and see it cheaper elsewhere, or whatever. However, I'm glad to say I've finally bought from Geek Garage for the first time. Here is the box there. It's got all the Geek Garage tape around it. And the main reason I bought from Geek Garage this time, for the first time, was because to celebrate 18 months of the website being online, Paul from Geek Garage had given an 18% off code on Instagram. So I thought, well, come on, 18% off Funko Pops. I've got to go and buy something. And I didn't buy one thing. I didn't buy two things. I bought three things. And it's quite a mixed bag here. Quite impulsive, really, all of these. But they'll all fit in my collection. And I'm really happy. And the prices that I will have paid with 18% off. Delighted. Postage, I think, was £5. Right, packaging-wise... excellent, plenty of bubble wrap on top. I can see one of the pops that's wrapped very well. I think I'll get the smallest item out first. Yes, this one. So here is only the third one of these in my collection. And it's a little pocket pop keychain. This is to celebrate 80 years of Batman, but it's based on the Adam West Batman from the classic 1960s TV series. Here is a Geek Garage exclusive, apparently. Batman pocket pop keychain. So I believe this was originally a Hot Topic release 2019 or something like that in America, but this now is exclusive in the UK at least to Geek Garage, which I think is pretty cool for a little UK independent. I remember this being announced by Geek Garage a couple of months or so back, and I thought, oh, that's cool. I don't really collect the pocket pops and the keychains as a rule, but if I get one in like a box or as a gift or to build an order up, then fine. And I thought, you know what, because I have collected the 1960s Batman pops, there's somewhere behind me there. I thought, you know what, this will be a nice little addition. Another Batman for the collection. I've got Batman in his Batmobile from the 60s TV show. And of course, I've got the 18-inch Batman down there. That was a brilliant price from Amazon earlier this year. So why not? Little Batman pocket pop keychain. I'm not going to get it out. I've never got any of these keychains out, as I'm always worried with my sausage fingers. I'm going to F the box up. But really happy with that. That'll just fit nicely with my two other mini pops. Right, next pop. This is probably the most random and impulsive of the purchases here, really, as I've never had anything in this line before. But I saw the price. It was £8.99 at Geek Garage, and that was before the 18% discount that I added. And I thought, you know what, this is just going to look really cool with some other pops that I've got right behind me. And you'll see why when I show you. It's a special edition, number 23, in the, I'm assuming, Conan O'Brien line. And it is Conan O'Brien dressed as a luchador. Classed as Team Coco presents Conan Without Borders. So yeah, quite impulsive. However, I'm not totally unfamiliar with Conan O'Brien. I know who he is. He's a comedy writer, comedian, chat show host. He's hosted one or two different late night American talk shows for many years now. I'm probably most familiar with his work writing in the early years for The Simpsons. And anyone who's a Simpsons fan, I don't think I'll ever meet any Simpsons fan who disagrees. The early stuff, the 1990s Simpsons, back when Conan was a writer on it, that's the golden era for The Simpsons. this just caught my eye. I thought it was a good price for a stickered pop, and I think he'll look really good with my Marvel Lucha Libre pops there as well. Building a little luchador section there is my idea, really. We can see a line on the back. There's loads of Conan O'Brien pops that have come out. Too many, really, I think. This is someone who, here in the UK, if you know him, then you kind of only really know him from sort of like clips on YouTube and things like that, but he's not someone who is particularly a big celebrity outside of the US, I would say. But on the back here, we've got number 21 is Bavarian Conan, so a German type Conan there. Number 22, K-pop Conan, so just dressed like one of these Korean boy band members. Yuck. 23 is the one I've got, Luchador Conan, and 24 is Armenian Conan. So, yeah, Conan O'Brien dressed as a luchador, which I think he did do for, presumably, a segment in his talk show. I think this may have been a GameStop exclusive over in the US. Over here we get the dreaded silver and red special edition sticker that triggers the Poptimist. Shout out to Darren. Really nice box as well. I love the design with all the Conan Without Borders logos and things in the background. So yeah, for $8.99, well, less really, as with 18%, oh, I can't remember the exact price of these, then very happy with Luchador Conan O'Brien. Right, I purchased one more thing from Geek Garage. This is the big ticket item, really. This is like the exciting thing. It's literally the biggest. There again, like the other two products, packaged really well. It's actually sandwiched. It's wedged very well in this box here. Let's be careful and get this out as best we can. There we are. Shut that box down. And you know, I've been collecting a lot of these recently. Now this one, I do feel a little bit of a hypocrite buying it. And those of you who know me well and have spoken to me particularly privately about music and things will know why I feel a little bit kind of getting this. But it was, I think, $13.99 at Geek Garage, and then when you've got almost 20% off, you're making a saving of what, well over £2, about £2.50 or something. So for a pop album, I just couldn't resist. And I thought, you know what, I like the figure that it is and the design of the album, even if I'm not the biggest fan of the band. And what I got is number 6 in the album's line. This is News of the World by Queen. Wow. So yeah, I say it every time I unbox these albums, but I bloody love them. I'm kind of tempted now to just collect them all. Like, I can think of a couple that are probably quite hard to get now for a good price. And even though I'm not massively fond of the act, then it'd just be nice to have a full set of something, really. But Queen, News of the World, this was their, I don't know what album this was in their chronology. I always associate Queen more as being a singles act, really. You think of Queen and Freddie Mercury, Brian May, etc. You think of like their big singles, like A Kind of Magic, We Will Rock You, Bohemian Rhapsody, obviously. Although I do know of quite a few of their albums. They did one called A Night at the Opera. I think they did one called A Day at the Races. They had Queen, the self-titled album, which was probably their debut. Queen 2, Innuendo, obviously, towards the end of their run, back when Freddie was getting really poorly. I don't rate Queen massively as an act. In a way, it's more sort of how I judge them kind of ethically rather than their music. I do like some of their music, and believe it or not, I have had Queen in my music collection before. I remember, God, over 20 years ago, I bought the 2000 remix Under Pressure CD single, Queen and David Bowie. That burns a building down, splits a family in two, puts people on streets. And I thought that was a brilliant mix of a really good track. Nothing Wrong with Under Pressure by Queen and Bowie, one of the strongest singles of the early 80s. But generally, and I won't go into it now, and I've talked to my friends about it privately as to why I dislike Queen for more ethical reasons than anything else. But, I mean, that's just a really cool pop and a really cool album sleeve. And we've got this Iron Giant type figure here. I believe the artwork for this album was based off some sort of sci-fi magazine or comic or something. Never listened to the album. I think the big single off it was We Will Rock You. Maybe We Are The Champions was on it as well. There'll be bigger Queen fans out there than me, because I'm not really a fan at all, who can obviously correct me if I'm wrong. But I just really rate these pop albums, and this is another one that's just going to look great in the collection here. Look at his red eyes, they're absolutely fantastic. So Queen's News of the World, love it. Another pop album. I'm really, really tempted now just to get all of them, regardless of... God, I hope they don't release a Gary Glitter one. No, they're not going to do that, are they? Although some Americans like don't really realise how taboo listening to Gary Glitter is here in the UK now, because you still hear some of his music like played at sports events and stuff. Yeah, do your homework, lads. Anyway, so yeah, three very different items here, non-related to one another at all. I think three Funko products that'll look brilliant in the collection. We've got this lovely little Adam West Batman 1960s keychain there, a Geek Garage exclusive. We've got, I really like this, I'm going to take it out later and have a proper look at it, Conan Without Borders, the Luchador Conan, which I just think will look fun with my Marvel Lucha Pops. And it had to be my favourite item because I just love the pop albums all day long. News of the World by Queen. So Geek Garage, my first order with them. I know a lot of my friends and peers on YouTube and social media generally have used Geek Garage numerous times, and I'm just glad that I was able to use them for the first time. Of course, I will endeavour to use Paul at Geek Garage again and purchase from him, because I got absolutely no complaints whatsoever with this order. Everything packaged up really safe and sound in lots of bubble wrap. The discount made everything even cheaper, so that's always a bonus. So thank you so much, Paul at Geek Garage, for this fantastic order, and I'll keep checking the site, and hopefully this will not be the first and last Geek Garage unboxing you see on this channel. Thank you all of you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this unboxing, and special thanks go, as they always do, to my subscribers and my generous patrons. Please see all my links down below for Funko affiliates, discounts, my Patreon page, Facebook group page, blah blah blah, blah yada yada yada. It's all down there. It's all damn tasty. I'm gonna go now, and I haven't got a protector for this little fella. I have got a protector for News of the World, and of course I've always got a normal size pop protector knocking around for Conan here, so I'm going to display all of these new additions to the collection, and I do hope that all of you will join me again next time for my next Funko Pop and Pocket Pop and Pop Album unboxing. Cheers everyone, see ya!